Picata at 14-1, March Akita at 10s, Dinky Flyer at 11-1, Raffolini a terrific chance, particularly if he gets over from his wide alley. He's at 9-2, a fraction better at the moment on the tab. Swift Chevelle at 5-1, 25 Sound of Bells. Wing Commander is out, 60-1 So Tip. Vainglorious is out, 60, 6-0 Max Treasure. My tip, I think she'll give a hell of a sight, and what great odds she is. Dance Hall Girl just firming a little bit, just over 12-1 still on the tote. And Rendu, boy oh boy, he might be under the odds. He's only 3-1. I don't like him. My tip, Dance Hall Girl, and you're sure getting big value for your money.
Okay, Ken, and Swift Chevelle is the last one up into the gates, and now they're boxed and ready to go in the Tui's Frederick Clissold Handicap. 1,200 metres, a great field of sprinters. A number of them looking burly and above themselves in condition, naturally enough. The likes of Periscope, Dinky Flyer, coming back from spells. Drawn hasn't raced since the Perth Carnival. Gates open, they're off. Pretty good start. March Akita and Dinky Flyer a little slow. They both went back towards the tail. And Raffolini bounded out in front, but Dance Hall Girl and Rendu have scooted up and they're going to make him work early. And now Picata dives between horses to head them all off. Picata in front at the end of 200 metres, getting to second. Raffolini, Rendu third. Dance Hall Girl steadied running fourth. Swift Chevelle is trapped out about three deep as they come through the gap onto the course proper. And then Sound of Bells and Drawn, followed by March Akita, Max Treasure, well back Periscope and Dinky Flyer, and last of all is So Tip at the 600 metres mark now, and Picata just led Raffolini, a length and a half behind them, Rendu in the box seat on the inside of Swift Chevelle. Dance Hall Girl is fifth into the straight, and then Sound of Bells Drawn midfield, further back March Akita, followed by Max Treasure and Periscope, but heads are turned for home now, and Swift Chevelle is the one to go after Raffolini and Picata, behind those Rendu block for a run, and Dance Hall Girl is running on strongly. Swift Chevelle headed Raffolini at the 200 mark. Dance Hall Girl running on well. Rendu was switching back to the fence again. Swift Chevelle drew clear with 100 to go, however, over Raffolini and Rendu, and Swift Chevelle too good, and he's racing away and he scores brilliantly. Look at Dinky Flyer. She's jumped out of the ground and might get second to nose in front of Raffolini or Rendu. Dance Hall Girl ran a big race, followed by So Tip and Periscope. At the head of the others then came Max Treasure, March Akita. Drawn as well back in the field, and the last couple were Sound of Bells and Picata. A great win to Swift Chevelle, ridden by Nigel Tiley, and that's another winner that Malcolm Johnson has missed out on. Mel out nursing multiple injuries after that heavy fall at Warwick Farm last Tuesday week. I know he was very sweet on Swift Chevelle. He'll be watching this right now. Never mind, son. Your day will come, Malcolm. Your day will come. Swift Chevelle, Nigel Tiley, trained by Paul Sutherland, and he's a good horse. The Doncaster is his mission on Easter Saturday. Kenny Callender, what do you like in the last?
In race 8, I'm tipping the Tommy Smith trained Mohegan, TAB number 3. Now, he's first up from a spell, and if you're looking for a bad tip for him, the thing is that the stable jockey Mick Dittman preferred the ride on the favourite, It's Lunchtime. I reckon Mick might have made a mistake, and It's Lunchtime is only going to be about 7-4, while Mohegan is at reasonably good odds. He's resuming from a spell this afternoon, Mohegan, but he's worked particularly well at Randwick, and on his best form, I think he's very well placed against this team of mainly second raters. He'll give you a super sight, and he'll be well ridden by Noel Barker. Number 3, Mohegan.
OK, Ken, then we'll see you for the last live at 10 minutes after 5.
Bill, and this is in fact the 27th race that we have covered here on 7 Sport today. Hope you back the winner. Hope you back the winner of this. Here's Ron Paps.
With the Inter Dominion heats tonight, Moonee Valley and Globe Derby Park all coming through with Peter Smith, your host at Globe Derby. They're ready. Racing now, and Muffler from the inside jumped well. Going up to it though, Magnum Special, Chorus Music, and also putting in the pressure, a Eureka Stockade. And Just a Hobo is up vying for the lead in the early part on settling, and as they sort themselves out, Kotiko's also gone up into the forward line, and he's trying to take hold of Just a Hobo to settle it now. And as they sort themselves out, it's Kotiko, Eureka Stockade and Magnum Special, a line of three. About two lengths away, Chorus Music outside of Just a Hobo, who's got all fired up and he's having having to restrain him. Around the outside of those is Catchman, followed by Mighty Verdict, well kept, and then further back came Storm Joy. About three lengths away to Muffler, followed further back in the field then by Disco Gambler. Back behind it, two lengths away, Bourbon Boy, and about three away last of all are Bread and Wine and Chugach. As they go past the 800 metre mark, Eureka Stockade shrugs off the other two and draws three quarters of a length Magnum Special. Catchman goes up at three deep before the turn. Just a Hobo getting into the clear now, working into the action, and so too there is Katiko. Chorus Music the outside, well kept, is pushing through. Magnum Special dropping out. Disco Gambling right around them. Bourbon Boy is starting to work home from Muffler, following it up. They were followed by Mighty Verdict, Homeward Bound, and here Just a Hobo goes up and draws on turns with Eureka Stockade. Well kept was next, then further back to Catchman, but under the whip, followed then by Disco Gambler and Muffler and Bourbon Boy, but the leader is Just a Hobo. Well kept's trying to get to it, but Just a Hobo in front. Just a Hobo hanging on, and the Hobo is home. He gets there. He's won it today. One length on the line almost, a well-kept Disco Gambler. Then Muffler, then came on the outside Bread and Wine. They were followed further back by Mighty Verdict, Catchman, Bourbon Boy out deep, followed by Storm Joy, then Storm Music and further Chorus Music, further back Katiko, well back then Eureka Stockade, followed by Chugach, and last of all Magnum Special.
Well, despite the fact that he pulled very hard in the early stages, Just a Hobo, the favourite, has been too good, number five. And there he is going to the line to beat number four, Well Kept, and number three, Disco Gambler. Five, four and three, the numbers, as called by Ron Paps after the running of race six, the Lord Dudley Handicap. Today, paying $1.15 and 70, Carb number seven was second, $4.15, Pipstay third, $1.30, Quinella $24.45, Trifecta $1.91.25. In race two, it was Shackle number four, $4.55 and $1.55, coming from well back. Six, Goddessa, $1.15. Seven, Show of Flowers, $1.30. The Quinella, $12.30, and the Trifecta, $128.75. The third race, Cossack Warrior, also came from well back in the early stages and won impressively, paying $1.05 and 70. Celtic Air number three, $1.85, and eight, Jano, $2.60. The Quinella, $9.10, and the Trifecta, $151.60. The fourth race on the card was the Herald Sprint, and what a win by Luther's Luck, storming down the outside to pay $3 and $1.10. Singing Wonder number 14 paid $3.45 and 11 Wild Rampage 85 cents. The Quinella paid $55.70 and the Trifecta $391.95. The fifth event on the card was the Blue Diamond Stakes.
Going very well, though. It's got Proven Valor beaten out wide on the track now. Midnight Fever. He's getting anxious on Rancho Ruler. Midnight Fever's racing to it on the outside. Jimmy Courtney riding for dear life. He's hit the front on the filly Midnight Fever, just in front of Rancho Ruler twining. And Midnight Fever's going to win the Blue Diamond by two lengths to Rancho Ruler. Third placing goes to Twining from Proven Valor, Ligon Arms, Mighty Dear.
Yes, Midnight Fever, a great win. Jimmy Courtney successful, paying $2.60 and 95. Number two, Rancho Ruler, 85 cents. And number 11, Twining, $1.15. The Quinella, $3.90. And the Trifecta, $50.35 on the big one. Race six was the Caulfield Autumn Classic, and a brilliant performance by Mayo Card, paying $2.50 and 90. 13, Princess Calabrina, $3.85. 5, Hunza's Ace, $1.25. The Quinella paid $60.50 and the Trifecta $1,025.45. Race 7 on the card was the Futurity Stakes, and Ribbiton leads them around the turn.
Phoenix Wider out on the track, coming out after them, and then at Talak. With about 200 to go, Rubiton's doing well. A half length in front and kicking away from Campaign King. King Phoenix the danger. Then Playful Princess. Rubiton clear. King Phoenix trying to peg him back, but Rubiton's holding him safely. And Rubiton wins well. A length and a half, King Phoenix. Playful Princess third.
Rubiton successful in the Futurity. Great performance. $2.75 and $1.05. Number two, King Phoenix, $1.45. Number six, Playful Princess, $1.35. The Quinella, $14, and the Trifecta, $174.10. Right, there's a bit of a problem at Caulfield with all smoke on the way to the barrier, and the rider Stephen Burridge has just remounted, so no harm done there, and the grey is just about to take its place in the stalls at the 1600 metre mark. Well, at Kilmore,